finally managed to get my hands on one of these Star Wars Rogue One Imperial Death Trooper as part of the vintage collection. Thanks to these guys. Thank you very much. Link in the description below to pick it up at Dark Side Toys. Hopefully they've got some left. I believe they were getting even more coming in later on. A lot of people have been trying to buy these, and a lot of sneaky scalpers picking them up as well from Dark Side and then immediately flipping them on eBay. But thankfully they put a bit of a stop to that. What a bunch of scumballs, man. Anyway, this is 4 inches tall, as is usual, 3.75 inches in scale. And we get, finally, this really cool card with the Rogue One logo up at the top. Looking very nice indeed. And the Death Trooper, looking very smart. Now, you'll notice it's really the Death Trooper Commander as such. I think it was a specialist. This one does not have the armor, so truly he is a Death Trooper, but this figure isn't quite. But I guess if you took the belt off, you do get the best of both worlds. We get the nice photograph with that blaster with that kind of steel tube on the end, and all the little bits and pieces there, the belt, that kind of iconic belt with the symbol on it, almost like Wi-Fi, and the Kenner logo. Very nice. Finally got one of these. VC127 is the number, and there's some text on the back if you want to freeze frame. All of the figures in the vintage collection are reviewed in our dedicated playlist. Lots and lots of stuff in different languages. Don't stick it up your nose, and the UPC should you need it. I really thought at one point, I wondered whether Hasbro was just going to cancel a lot of these because the order was waiting for so long, and I never saw them anywhere else. They literally just did not appear anywhere. Never saw them in stores, never saw them anywhere else online. I don't know why they would not make an abundance of these, but Hasbro didn't. Anyway, this is the figure loose, and it has been released before, earlier on, in the black and red Black Series collection. Not the vintage collection, the Black Series collection. Let me get a bit of a close-up on this, and we'll do some zooming in to show you the details if you haven't yet seen our previous review of this guy. But it's a very, very nice figure, and yes, some nice details. He is all jet black, but there are some nice little parts and pieces in there. Basically, the green on the visor is a little bit hard to see, but it is there. It's a nice, dark, metallic green going on. You get a little bit of chrome at the front of the mouthpiece there, and the green tubes at the front, a little bit of silver on the ammo pouches. And the blaster's really cool too. It's got a kind of silvery chrome colour. They actually do have a little, very faint little bit of blast jet effect at the end there, but it does the job, looks good. A little bit of red on the blaster. Let's take that out of his hand. And you can see he holds it really well, so it's a very cool figure that way. No wonder these scalpers were after these, because the prices were going crazy beforehand. There you go, there's three kind of grenades he's got there on his belt, looking very good. And as I said, that is removable if you want to. You could snap that off. But some nice detail in the back of it. Love these Death Troopers. And we're going to get to see more of them in time. And again, this specialist piece here, I think, no, that was all the Death Troopers. This kind of visor-like piece here is nice, done in a chrome colour. And jet black all the way. And interestingly enough, if you recall when I did the 6-inch review, not that you probably do, but I do, these three little darts or whatever they are on the forearm are silver here, but they weren't on the 6-inch, which was just a bit of a shame. Silver on the belt, as we mentioned, with those little three symbols, which appeared, I think, once on Vader's belt, was it? I can't remember. But a very nice, nice figure. And we get a very annoying stamp here, just kind of right out in the open. I do not know why, but there we go. Why that couldn't be put right in the back of the leg? Ah, never mind. But pretty good overall. Plenty of articulation on him, and we'll get to that in just a second. Now, he does have this poldon, so it does restrict movement even more. But we do get a ball joint on that head there, so there's a fair range of motion on the go. Ball joint up at the top of the shoulders. You've got an elbow joint there. You have got a swivel wrist and back and forth action. So really good for, again, holding that blaster in some awkward poses. You do have underneath there a swivel waist. And actually moves pretty well considering that ammo belt's around there too. It's really a bit of an ab crunch, to be honest, more than a waist articulation. Then we've got pegs up at the top, or, yep, little ratcheted pegs up at the top there. There is a thigh swivel too, you can just see that there. You've got a single joint at the knees, Oops, I've got the knee around the wrong way. That's just why that's going to be a little bit awkward. Oop, there we go. Joint at the knees and a rocking ankle there. And pickles, pretty shallow pickles, but we got them. Great army builder. Very, very pleased to get them. And again, my thanks to these guys, Dork Suit Toys, for having them. If they have sold out, hang fire to the new store. I believe they're going to have maybe potentially some more. And as always, there will be a limit on them. These sneaky scalpers out there, unreal. Anyway, so good to get this on a card. Let me know if you're having difficulty in getting this. Did you manage to get an order with these guys? Because I honestly never saw this anywhere. Did not see it once anywhere. It might have been maybe in a case or something. I don't know. Anyway, blink and it was gone. A very, very hard figure to get in the vintage collection, as they all seem to be getting some of them these days. But love to know your thoughts in the comments. And yeah, let us know below. And we'll see you for another review coming right up. Cheers.